already. It's full of all my thoughts and secrets.
Marty will go to eat his orange. He wanted to sit on a tree and be a school tree. This is come first.
I'll be glad to look for you, Basingo.
Marty searched in his desk. He found out that Marty was brownie furniture bracelet to the pencil. I dropped even a collection of body shoes, but not from a diary. Marty asked Emma when she had seen it last.
I had it with me at lunch. I remember because I almost spilled milk on it. I had it with me when Mr. Dix told us about the movie. It wasn't there after the movie ended.
Marty left the movie to stay in the bus. It was about to the start of the movie. The movie started and the jump was too long. The solar system showed before. When Mr. Dix went to fix his truck, he locked the movie. The little film was screaming.
Watch the movie was good. Listening to Mr. Dix was not. Did someone steal Emma's diary while pressing the start? Or did someone want to know Emma's deeds? It's time to ask him this question.
Marty wondered.
Pete took paper, air, and cups. He liked to take things. He took Marty's poetry for last week.
Where did he walk the movie?
Did you see Bobo from the bottom?
I'm busy.
Marty took a play of crayons.
I'll keep it brief. Are you the thief? No!
Mary grabbed her crayon back.
No!
Marty made a list of all the people who might have stolen Emma's diary. Billy Dirty was first on the list. He always teased Emma. Last week, he hit a dead butterfly in a tuna fish stand. Emma found it just yesterday. She thought it was yellow with letters. Billy might just be his
tip on his head. Tell him, Mr. Bailey. Read any good books lately?
No, there are no horror books at the library.
What kind of books? I was thinking more of a personal story. Not the kind that's really boring.
Billy shook his head.
I don't like that kind of stuff.
Well, you got to have some explaining to do, because I see a book that's blue.
Goblins and vampires from the page. Billy grabbed the book back.
For Mrs. Violet Foster. What's your problem anyway? And then whispered to
my diary is smaller than that. It's a darker shade of blue. Plus, my handwriting is much neater. And I don't draw monsters.
We could have told you before. Those kind of details are hard to ignore.
Well, Lee kept asking me about it. She wanted one for her birthday, but she didn't get one.
Lee was still outside for recess. Monty followed her from the swings.
sets, hopscotch, to the basketball court, to the fence, to the lunch area. She put a blue book.
Aha! Caught you in act. And that's a fact. Hand over the diary.
Zara, happy birthday to you. To me, happy birthday to you. Some did. But I hope you're still friends with mom.
We're not. I want my money back. You gave me no fee.
I'm doing this for free.
Well, you're a lousy detective.
Marty got involved. Idea is the best place to look for a book. Of course, the library. They hurried down the hall. Marty asked the librarian for help.
Have you seen something small and blue?
No, but have you checked for what the bound?
Marty emptied the box on the shelf. He found a left boot, a red mitten, a broken comb, a nickel which he claimed, a bag of acorns, a compass, and a box. The closest thing to a diary is a compass. He kept that for evidence.
Marty hoped he would solve the case by then.
Any luck?
Marty shook his head.
We don't have much time. Back to the scene of the crime.
Marty exclaimed a little again. He looked at the roll of yellow ribbon from his detective coat. He looked at the radio around his desk. Now he could study the crime scene.
Can think of a rhyme for that.
Orange is a mo in a mo rhyme.